Hey everyone, welcome back. Many times you might have seen that the succulent leaves fall on the ground, they root themselves and grow into plants. So it's definitely easy growing succulents from single leaf cuttings. You just have to keep few things in mind to increase the chances of success. Today I'm going to share with you all the tips and tricks to successfully grow succulents just from a single leaf. So let's get started. The first and the most important step of this process is to choose a healthy leaf and pluck it cleanly from the mother plant. Always start with a healthy, perfect leaf cutting because it has a better chance of becoming into a new plant. We are going to choose the leaves which are healthy, plump and mature. Don't pluck the small new leaves near the top. Leaves which are deformed or discolored, or the leaves which have some type of spots or marks on it are not suitable for propagation. Carefully remove the entire leaf off the stem and hold the leaf close to the base and gently wiggle it side to side until it comes off. It's really important to remove the whole leaf cleanly from the stem. No part of the leaf should be left on the stem. And don't pull the leaf to remove it, because it may tear. Here I am comparing side by side two types of leaf cuttings. A pair of good cuttings are in the left and a pair of bad cuttings are in the right. And we are going to discard the leaves which are broken or damaged because poor leaf cuttings don't sprout roots or form a new plant. Now let the leaf cutting sit around for 2 to 7 days until the cut ends, that is the part where the leaf was attached to the stem, dry out and form a callus. Don't skip this step. This step is really important. It prevents rotting of the leaf cuttings. And once you feel that the leaf cuttings are dry enough, you can propagate them either in soil or in water. Here I am using my homemade succulent potting mix. It provides good drainage and aeration in soil. Just place the leaves flat on top of the soil and keep them in a place where they receive bright but indirect sunlight. To avoid overwatering, I prefer to use a spray bottle to mist the soil whenever the top layer soil is dry. Just keep in mind, we want the top layer soil to stay slightly moist but not soggy. If there is too much water, the leaves will rot and die. Now you will have to wait patiently for the roots and baby plants to grow from the leaves. This can take weeks to months depending on the succulent you are working with, and it also depends on the environmental conditions. After a few weeks, you will see that the roots have started to grow from the leaves. Gently cover the roots with soil so that they don't dry out. Generally, the leaves grow roots first and then the baby plants grow. But sometimes it is just the opposite. Here you can see that the baby plants have grown from the leaves, but the roots have not yet sprouted. Don't worry, just place them back on the soil. As the baby plants grow, the leaves will sprout roots. Once the baby plants are nearly 1 inch tall and their roots are well established, you can transplant them in new pots. Generally, the mother leaves wither away as the baby plants grow. Here you can see that the new plants have grown from the leaves and they have well-developed roots. But the mother leaves that were used for propagation are still healthy. At this point, you can either wait for the mother leaves to dry up first and then transplant the new plants. I usually prefer to wait. You can also transplant them at this stage. Simply pot up the new plants along with the mother leaves. Gradually, mother leaves will wither away on their own as the new plants grow. leaf cuttings, and you can see most of the mother leaves have withered. Now just gently twist and wiggle the mother leaves away from the new plants and plant them in separate pots. These new plants are delicate and they can't tolerate full sun. So keep them in bright indirect light until they are fully established. And water them when the top layer soil is dry. These growing succulents need a little more water than the fully grown succulents. You can also propagate your succulent leaves in water. It is generally recommended that the leaves should be placed on water in a way so that the leaf ends stay slightly above the water level. I was curious to see what happens if we dip the leaf ends in water. So I tried this with some of my leaf cuttings, and here you can see they have also developed healthy root system and they have grown baby plants too. The leaves of some succulents like mother of thousands grow tiny plantlets along its edges. They are the easiest plants to propagate. In fact, you can grow a bunch of new plants just from a single leaf. And just like seeds, they sprout roots and form new plants wherever they fall. There are two simple ways to propagate them. You can remove the plantlets from the leaves and just lay them on soil. No need to plant them in soil. Mist the plants when the top layer soil is dry and soon the plantlets will sprout roots. Or you can remove the whole leaf from the mother plant and place it flat on the top of the soil. And once the new plantlets are established, simply remove the mother leaf and plant them in separate pots. All kinds of succulents cannot be propagated by a single leaf, and there are some varieties of them which are easier to propagate than the others. Let's have a look at some of the succulents that I have grown easily just from a single leaf. I have experimented with many of my succulents and learned a lot through trial and error. Succulents like Echeveria, Graptopetalum, Sedum are good choices for beginners to start with. So now you know how easy it is to make new succulents just from a single leaf. The methods are really simple, but you have to keep few things in mind. Since not every leaf will turn into a new plant, start working with several leaf cuttings. And it takes quite a while for the leaves to form a decent sized plant. So you will have to be very patient. That's it for today. I hope you all will be able to do it successfully, and I would love to know how it goes for you. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below.